what we usually have done is we give money to buy medical equipment, and that's been our main focus. But obviously with Small Acts of Friendship we wanted to do something different, and what we wanted to do was to run a campaign which would help raise our profile, which would help raise some money, and most important, to do something that was actually working with a doctor and the medical teams, helping them realise their vision. We spent about £500,000 last year buying a range of equipment for virtually all the departments, actually. I hope what we can do is do a few things that are beyond the basic requirements. So perhaps a piece of kit that they might not be able to afford, that's a little bit marginal, or perhaps some help that actually gives patients a slightly better quality of life and experience.
So we're launching an initiative called Small Acts of Friendship, and it's a joint project between the friends of the hospitals and the clinicians in the hospital, us in the elderly medicine department. And the idea is that we know that hospital can be quite isolating for patients sometimes, and they can feel quite lonely, they can feel like they're not part of a community, and it can be quite scary actually. And our staff are amazing, the nurses that I work with, the doctors that I work with are amazing people, and I think they couldn't do more in terms of the care and compassion they give, but there's a limit to what we can do. So this is sort of additional extra stuff to make your hospital, the older patients' hospital, stay that bit better. And we hope that it will aid recovery, help people get better quicker, help people get home quicker, make people more likely to get back to their own home, get back to independence. So the sort of things we're going to be doing are, just for example, getting people's nails done if they want that, getting their hair done, making them look a bit nicer, bringing pat dogs in so people can have a bit of interaction, having volunteers to read with people or get the papers and go through them with somebody. We might have art sessions where people can join in, singing, individualised music. So there's lots of different aspects of the project, and these are all things that we've sort of done in bits on the wards, but not really done in a big coordinated way. So we have musicians who come into some of the wards, and you know, we do various things, but not in a sustained way, and not for everybody, if you like. It's sort of patchy. There's also some stuff around nutrition, trying to give people cooked breakfast, helping them with feeding a bit, and things like cake, you know, sort of social food that you can all join in and have a slice of cake. We also want to do some work around people who are dying and their families, and because there's nowhere really at the moment for families to be in our building. If there's somebody who's very unwell, you sort of have to be in a chair by their bedside. So the thing that's different is the friends are going to fund a coordinator post. So that's a role, a job of somebody who will coordinate all this stuff, make sure it's happening, make sure it's getting to the right patients, and sort of sustain it really, because what we find is we launch an initiative and then it goes very quickly. So it's really that job is really important, and that's what they've agreed to fund. So that's amazing, and we're so grateful to the friends for funding that. I think it's more about hospital isolates you because you're out of your network, you're out of your friend, you know, older people obviously have their friends and their networks, but taking them into hospital almost removes them from that. So it's trying to bring that in somehow in the hospital, that's the idea.
It's a particularly truly amazing idea because it makes such a difference to older patients. Just something as simple as a piece of cake and a cup of tea can really, really boost their morale and everything, and so on and so forth. It's managed by the elderly care team at the Royal Sussex County Hospital, so we're very grateful, I think, that they're here today to actually recognise what's going on, and we're hoping they want to raise about £100,000 so that they can fund a new member of staff who will be absolutely dedicated to get elderly patients to regain their confidence. I just want to wish this project every success and encourage everybody in there to make a donation to support Small Acts of Friendships and to enhance the life of local older people residents in our wonderful city.